and was not completed until 1929. On June 1st of 1929, a grand funeral ceremony was held to commemorate Dr. Sun.
We're now standing at the Mausoleum Gate. It's a single eave and gable roof with blue glazed tiles.
Four Chinese characters, Tian Xia Wei Gong, are inscribed over the doorways written by Dr. Sun Yatsen. It means the world is for all people, delivering his commitment to republicanism.
Walking through the Mausoleum Gate, the first building we see is the Tablet Pavilion.
The 24 Chinese characters engraved here says, Premier Dr. Sun is buried here by Kuomintang on June 1st, 1929.
This long stairway leads from the Tablet Pavilion all the way up to the Sacrificial Hall over there. It seems we still have got a long way to go. Come on!
These stairs are divided into 8 flights. The number 8 represents the three people's principles and constitutions of 5 powers proposed by Dr. Sun. The people's principles refer to 民族, the principle of nationalism. It encourages people to seek independence from imperialist domination. 民权, the principle of democracy. It advocates a people's power or a government by the people. And 民生, the principle of people's livelihood. It highlights social welfare. In the constitutions of 5 powers, 5 administrative institutions of the national government were set up to govern the country. They are the constitution of legislation, justice, supervision, administration, and examination.
Actually, if you count from the memorial archway right from the beginning, you will know that we've just climbed 392 stairs. Quite a workout. And this number signifies 392 million Chinese people at the time.
On the top of the stairs comes the sacrificial hall. This is the highest spot of Dr. Sun Yatsen's mausoleum. Remember the alarm bell? If the long stairway we just passed was a bell rope, the sacrificial hall, together with the coffin chamber behind, would make the striker. On the platform in front of the hall, we can see 2 blue stone tripods, which were presented by Mr. Sun Ke, the eldest son of Dr. Sun. On each side, there is 1 ornamental column like those in Tiananmen Square. They seem like piercing into the sky with strong stereoscopic impression. The sacrificial hall is the main structure of the mausoleum. A vertical inscribed board under the eave is inscribed with 4 Chinese characters, Tian Di Zheng Qi, in Dr. Sun Yatsen's handwriting, meaning the true essence of heaven and earth. This is Dr. Sun's exhortation to people to keep honest and upright. Underneath, the 3 arched doors of the sacrificial hall are inscribed the 3 people's principles we just mentioned: nationalism, democracy, and people's livelihood. Entering the sacrificial hall, right in the middle is a 4.6-meter white Italian marble statue of Dr. Sun Yatsen in sitting position. He wears long gown, eyes facing forward, and an open book on his lap, which demonstrates the wisdom of the great thinker. It is a vivid reflection of Dr. Sun working for democracy and revolutionary activities. At the foot of the statue sit 6 pieces of carvings about his revolutionary activities. Looking up, the ceiling is inlaid with a mosaic emblem of Kuomintang. Behind the memorial hall is the coffin chamber. The whole tomb is hemispherical in shape, with the white marble coffin of Dr. Sun Yatsen set in the center of the chamber. His white marble statue rests atop the rectangle coffin where this historical giant forever sleeps. The entire Mausoleum scenic area creates an atmosphere of solemnity and reverence, paying the deepest tribute to Dr. Sun's noble spirit and heroic efforts. In memory of his devotion to the Chinese people's fight against oppression for the independence of the country.
Okay, what we've seen, Dr. Sun Yat-sen's Mausoleum is just a part of the Zhongshan Mountain National Park. Nearby the Mausoleum, there are the music stage, the Meiling Palace, the Suture Depository, and the other auxiliary memorial buildings. Come and check by yourself. You will like it here.